Good morning, everyone, and welcome to C3 Church Klang. I am so happy to see all of you here in person and online. My name is Bella and I'm your host for today. We are going to start our celebration in just a few moments with our worship team. If you are here online, please join us in our praise and worship. Make this time a special moment for you and your loved ones. And be sure to engage with us. We want to see you singing out loud with us in the comments. Yes, good moments should be shared. Please like this live video and be a blessing to your family and friends by sharing this wonderful worship experience on your Facebook page. Before we begin, please join me in this short prayer. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for this day and thank you for everything you have given us. And please bless the people that are online and here at church. And please guide us and lead us to the right way you taught us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Are you guys ready? Let's pass this time to our worship team to lead us in a powerful time of worship.
Everyone, and let's stand up and worship Lord together. Let's clap our hands. Let's go, church. Clap our hands together.
Today, yes, Lord, today.
let's just take Him in His presence right now. And whenever we are saying all these words, we are saying it to Him, to God. Hallelujah. And we'll say it from the bottom of our heart.
Christ is my firm foundation, the rock on which I stand, when everything around me is shaken. I've never been more glad that I put my faith in Jesus, 'cause He's never let me down. He's faithful through generations. So why would He fail now? He won't. He won't. I've got joy in chaos. I've got peace that makes no sense. So I won't be going under. I'm not held by my own strength, 'cause I build my life on Jesus. He's never let me down. He's faithful.
Came and the winds blew and beat against that house, yet it did not fall because it had been founded on rock. And who is the rock? In Psalms 18:2, it says that the Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer. My God, my rock, is where I take my refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation, and my stronghold, our firm foundation. So when we sing these words, let's sing it from our heart. We'll sing it no matter what we have gone through. God has always been there for us. So let's sing it together, church. Hallelujah. Let's put our hands out together and we'll just say it. Hallelujah. Yes.
Rain came, wind blew, my house was built on you. Save you, I'm gonna make
Let's sing it, church.
Rain came, wind blew, my house was built on you. Saints and angels, incense arise. Day and night, night and day, let incense arise. Day and night, night and day, let incense arise. Day and night, night and day, you are worthy of it all. We are standing here right now, Father. We could feel your spirit, Father. We could feel your presence, Lord. And God, we are taking this moment, Father, for us to sing as loud as we could, Father, and to say that you are worthy of it all, that you are worthy, Lord, that you are our Lord, our rock, our foundation. You are worthy of everything, Father. You are worthy of it all. That's right, church, sing it.
Worthy of it all.
Oh, yes, Lord. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory. You are worthy. Let's sing it again. You are worthy of it all. To you are all things. You deserve the glory. Far from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory. Let's be seated.
Welcome everyone. If you have just joined us, my name is Bella and welcome to C3 Church Klang. I would like to take a moment at this part of our service and take up today's offering. If you are new here, the offering is simply a chance to financially support what we are doing. It's also something God our Heavenly Father has called us to do as an act of trust. You may have never thought of giving as an act of trust, but it is. When you give, you're basically telling God, I trust that you will provide for me even as I give. And the great part about this statement of trust is that it's true. God can be trusted to sustain you even though you have a little bit less. We learn to trust and lean on God to provide for our needs. Giving helps us let go our hold on money and the benefits that we can provide for ourselves. Giving helps us release the anxiety and place our trust in Him. Matthew 6 says, Our Heavenly Father already knows all your needs. Seek the kingdom of God above all else and live righteously, and He will give you everything you need. Matthew 6 verse 32 to 33. For all of you here in church, our stewards will be passing the buckets around. If you would like to participate in today's offering, you can put something in the bucket. Please do give generously. If you wish to give online, scan the Do It Now QR codes located on the wall. If you are watching our service from your screens, just scan the QR code shown here. If you are watching our service from your mobile phones, our bank details are displayed on the screen. Take a screenshot and save these details for giving online later. Thank you so much for your generosity in working with us for the glory of His kingdom. There's a lot happening at our church, so let me take you through a few announcements.
So the Bible is one of the most influential books of all time, but what is it exactly?
Yeah, some people treat the Bible like a divine behavior manual that dropped out of heaven. Others use it like a theology dictionary, written to answer all of our questions about God. And others still think of it like a grab bag of spiritual one-liners and inspiring stories.
But here's the thing. The Bible isn't written as a rule book or theology dictionary or even as a collection of inspirational writings.
Then what is the Bible?
Well, open up the Bible to page 1 and read the opening words.
In the beginning.
Now, turn to the last chapter of the Bible where you can read this.
And they reigned forever and ever. Okay, so the Bible's telling a story from beginning to end.
Yeah, it's one epic narrative about how God has appointed humanity as his partners to oversee this amazing world. It's about how we've ruined that partnership and how God is restoring us and our world through Jesus.
Okay, one story, but there's a lot going on. Many plots, many characters, all written in many different books.
But once you see how every book has a careful literary design, you won't get lost. And you can see how it fits into the overall storyline.
There are also important repeated themes that weave through the entire biblical story.
Yeah, like the covenant that God makes with people.
Or the hope for a human who will confront evil.
Or how God's justice will one day make all things right. And every theme culminates in the story of Jesus.
There are also a lot of strange words in the Bible, words we don't use in normal language.
But when we take time to understand them, we discover profound ideas that contribute to the overall biblical story.
So it takes work to know how to read the different types of literature in the Bible.
But once you do learn how, you'll discover that the Bible is a work of literary genius that can transform how you live and how you think about everything.
So that's what the Bible Project is all about, to help people see the Bible as one unified story that leads to Jesus.
Thank you so much for being here with us today. Make sure to stay connected with us throughout the week online at C3 Church Klang on Facebook and Instagram. We believe God has something unique to say to you, and our hope is that you feel His love stronger today than ever before. Thanks again for being here with us. Back to you, worship team.
Thank you, Bella. Okay, church, let's stand around and greet one another. Let's give a hug as well. Thank you. Pastor Edward and Felicia to the stage. Hallelujah.
Alright, very good morning to all of you, church. It is the second day of Chinese New Year.
今天是新年, 农历新年的第二天,
it's still Chinese New Year.
Yeah.
So In this Chinese New Year, probably you see a couple of things.
那大家可能在农历新年的时候可以看到一些事情。
Okay, firstly, of course, you see the 红包.
第一，当然大家会看到红包。
Second thing, what do you see normally? Feast, yeah. You know, people who eat. You know, even the price is so expensive, people still eat.
大家呢还会看到家人们聚在一起开一个圣餐，虽然那个价格很贵，但是呢还是会一起吃东西。
And the third thing is.
第三样。
When you are about to sleep on Chinese New Year Eve.
那你除夕夜想要睡觉的时候，
and you thought it's about to finish, blah. You thought it's about to finish, right? Suddenly, blah 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 again.
大家就会听到像巴塞尔刚才所发出的那个炮竹声.
Okay, yeah. This is, in fact, actually, what is this really all about, actually, in this Chinese New Year?
那在新年这些都代表着什么呢?
Now, you see, in this season, we are to bless, but not to curse.
那在这个季节呢,我们是需要去祝福人家,而不是去诅咒人家。
Especially when we speak or when we do something.
尤其是当我们看到或者是在做一些事情的时候。
And even some superstitious one, they still observe some, I wouldn't say all, hopefully Christians not. They still observe that the first day cannot sapu, cannot sweep the floor at home, cannot.
那还有一些比较迷信的人呢，第一天农历新年第一天的话呢，他们还是有遵守那个第一天不可以扫地的这个习俗。
You know why you can't sweep the floor during the first day?
你知道为什么第一天不能扫地吗?
Superstitiously, they believe that if you sweep the floor on the first day, you will sweep away all your prosperity, all your monies, all your finances, all the good things sweep out from the house.
那他们相信，如果你在第一天扫地的话呢，你就会把你的财富呢，通通都扫出去了。And
some of these, the superstitious one also believe that the daughter, yeah, the daughter cannot go back to, whether it's the in-law's place, the in-law's, the mom's place before the second day of Chinese New Year.
那有一些呢，也是相信嫁出去的女儿呢，在第二天前呢，不可以回到娘家。
If not, if you come back earlier, then you will make the family poor.
那他们相信，如果你比第二天早回家，回娘家的话呢，你会使到那个你的娘家呢贫穷。
What all these beliefs, what do you think all these beliefs?
那你觉得这些相信是什么呢?
I think regardless of whether we are Indian friends or Indian neighbors, Malay neighbors, Chinese and all that, we all love blessings.
那我相信大家不管你的邻居是什么人,大家都喜欢被祝福。
This year, our team is called Life.
那今年呢,我们的主题是叫生命。
We love a life of blessings.
那大家都喜欢被赐福的生活,生命。
The scripture in John 10:10 say that to have life more abundantly.
那我们可以看到在约翰福音第十章第十节说到,我们需要有生命,需要有丰盛的生命。
As a follower of Jesus Christ,
那身为这个基督徒的跟随者,
He wanted you to have a blessed life.
他要我们有一个被赐福的生命。
He wants you to be blessed.
他想要你得福。
Same as our Father in heaven.
就好像我们天堂的天父一样。
So the title for today's message is called Be Blessed.
那今天呢，我的这个信息的这个题目呢，是愿你得福。
We like to go through and see how God set for His people to look at this Be Blessed, the life being blessed.
那我们一起看看上帝呢，想要他的子民呢，怎样得福。
And you see how Jesus also showed the examples of how one can be blessed.
以及呢，耶稣如何向我们展示一个人怎样能被得福呢?
Before that, let's pray.
那我们先一起祷告。
Father, we give thanks to you for this morning, for, for all of us that can come before to your house and to worship and to praise you, Father. Yes. We give thanks to you. Yes. Father, we know that we are a group of people that have been blessed by you, Father. Yes. This morning, as we listen to your words, Father, Lord, open our hearts, open our ears, Father, Lord, and let these words to come into us, Father, Lord, yes, to transform us, Father, yes, Lord. We thank you, Father, Lord. Lord, may these words will be blessed, Father, Lord. Yes. Lord, we thank you for all this time, we coming this time into your hand. Yes. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Okay, today our main scriptures draw from the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1 to verse 13, 14.
那今天我们首要的这个经文呢，是在《生命记》第28章第1到第13节。
Now it shall come to pass, if you diligently obey the voice of the Lord your God, to observe carefully of his commandments, which I command you today, that the Lord your God will set you high above all nations of the earth. And all these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you, because you obey the voice of the Lord your God. Blessed shall you be in the city, and blessed shall you be in the country. Blessed shall be the fruit of your body, the produce of your ground, and increase of your herds, to increase of your cattle, and the offspring of your flocks. Blessed shall be your basket and your kneading bowl. Blessed shall you be when you come in, and blessed shall when you go out.
那我们可以看到第一章到第六节说到，你若留意听从耶和华你神的话，谨守遵行他的一切诫命，就是我今日所吩咐你的，他必使你超乎天下万民之上。你若听从耶和华你神的话，这以下的福必追随你，临到你身上。你在城里蒙必蒙福，在田间也必蒙福。你生所生的，地所产的， 牲畜所下的以及牛犊羊羔都必蒙福，你的筐子和你的转面棚都必蒙福，你出也蒙福，入也蒙福。
The Lord will cause your enemies who rise against you to be defeated before your face. They shall come out against you one way and flee before you seven ways. The Lord will command a blessing on you in your storehouses and in all to which you set your with your hand, and he will bless you in the land which the Lord your God is giving you.
那可以看一下第七节说到，仇敌起来攻击你，耶和华必使他们在你面前被你杀败，他们从一条路来攻击你，必从七条路逃跑，在你仓房里，并你手所办的一切事上，耶和华所命的福必临到你，耶和华你神也要在所给你的地上赐福于你。
Now let's take a look of verse 12.
我们看一下第十二节。
The Lord will open to you his good treasure, the heavens, to give the rain to your land in its season, and to bless all the work of your hand. You shall lend to many nations, but you shall not borrow.
耶和华必为你开天上的库福，按时降雨在你的地上，在你手里所办的一切事上赐福于你，你必借给许多国民，却不致向他们借贷。Now,
today's message, we want to talk about be blessed.
那今天呢，我们想要说就是关于赐福。We
want to look at from a simple 3 points to see how one fellow Christians they can be blessed, or even if you are not a Christian, how you learn the way to be blessed.
那我们今天想要看一下有三个点，怎样呢会被赐福。
Point number one, the source of blessing.
那第一点，祝福的来源。
Meaning that you have to know where is this source come from, who is your blesser.
那你需要知道谁是你的赐福者。
Now the book of Deuteronomy is mostly made up of farewell speeches delivered by this Israel leader Moses.
那《生命记》的这本书大多是呢以色列的这个领袖摩西呢在布道中发表的一些告别的演讲。Moses
spoke about he took about 3 sessions of sermons to remind the Israelites.
那在三次的布道中呢，摩西呢一直在提醒着这些以色列人。It's
a reminder that Moses reminded the Israelites before they enter into the promised land, the Canaan land.
那他们呢，是摩西呢，在以色列进入迦南之地前呢，一直不断的提醒他们。
The Canaan land, it is a place that God promised his people.
那这个迦南之地呢，是上帝应许了这个以色列人的地方。
So in this book, in these remarks, Moses reminded the Israelites how they have got to where they are at the time.
摩西呢提醒了这些以色列人，他们怎样来到他们现在这个位置，这个地方。
How God has saved them from the slavery in Egypt.
上帝如何将他们从埃及的这个奴隶之中拯救出来。
How God has provided them in the desert.
那上帝呢怎样在这个沙漠中提供了给他们。
He reminds the Israelites that the promise or agreement made 40 years ago at Mount Sinai.
那他提醒了他们在四十年前呢，在西奈山呢，上帝与他们的这个协议。
At the same time, Moses also reminded them, "Do not repeat the same mistakes that these Israelites they have repeated."
那与此同时呢，他也提醒他们不要再重复着这个错误。
Now, if you look at Ten Commandments, we thought Ten Commandments is some form of laws.
那如果你看到这个十条诫命的话，我们认为呢，它是一些的律法。
Ten Commandments is not just about law.
它不只是一些律法。
Ten Commandments is about relationship.
它是一段感情。
It is a relationship. Firstly, the first four commandments is about relationship with God.
那首四条诫命呢，是我们与上帝的这个关系。
And then if you look at the other commandments, this is your relationship with your parents.
那其他的呢是我们跟我们家长啊，我们父母亲的关系。
And the rest of it is this relationship between we ourselves with our surroundings.
还有其他的是我们和我们周遭人的一些关系。
Okay, come back to Deuteronomy 28. What it says here is that it speaks about a life of blessings.There are 14 scriptures that we read this morning. It is about a life of blessings.
那今天早上呢，我们可以看到在生命记有14章呢，是讲到就是这个赐福的生命。
And with the rest of the scriptures in chapter 28, it speaks about curses. Curse.
那其他的章文呢，就讲到这些诅咒。
So in total, there are about 14 scriptures talk about blessings.
那有十四个章文呢，是讲到就是赐福的。
54 scriptures spoke about curses.
54节呢讲到诅咒。
Do you think it is easier to get blessings with 14 scriptures or to get curses for 54 scriptures?
那你觉得哪一个更容易呢？
Let's take a look of what the first two scriptures say.
那我们一起来看一下第一跟第二节说什么。
It says here that if you fully obey the Lord your God and carefully follow all his commands I give you today.
那他说到你若留意听从耶和华你神的话遵守谨守遵行他的一切诫命就我今日所吩咐你的。
Okay, it says here that if you look at it very carefully there are few key important processes here.
那如果你仔细看的话呢有几个重要的这个过程。
Okay, the first process over here it talks about listenAnd obey.
那第一个，他说到听从和遵守。
As I was studying these scriptures, I found out that a lot of scriptures over here it talks about obey.
那当我在阅读这些经文的时候，我就是学习到呢，很多都在讲做听从。
And finally, I found one version. Okay, found one version. New King James Version speaks here about.Obey the voice.
那我们可以看到呢，我们可以看到，就是这里有讲到遵守那个声音。
And I compared it against the Chinese translation.
然后我再跟华语的这个经文来比较。
It says in the Chinese translation, listen and obey.
那华语的这个经文呢，就说到要听从和遵守。
Okay, here we talk about a voice.Listen and obey. Obey the voice in New King James Version.
那我们可以看到这里是说到要服从声音。
And in the Chinese version, we talk about listen and obey.
然后华语的经文呢，说到听从和遵守。
So whose voice are we talking about here?
那这里的声音是指谁的声音呢？
It is the voice of the Lord.
是我们上帝的声音。
Okay, let's be realistic, let's be practical. In the world today, prior to listen to any of the voices, the key question here is that where do we listen our voices from?
那我们现实一点，在服从任何的声音之前呢，这里的关键问题是我们是听从谁跟哪里的声音呢？
Whenever we have challenges, whenever we have difficulties, whenever we are sick, where do we listen these voices from?
当我们面对一些挑战的时候，我们是听从哪里的声音，谁的声音？
Our surroundings?
是我们周遭的声音吗？
Social media?
社交媒体。
Or speculations,
还是一些猜测
or superstitious way, or some self-thought, self-righteous way,
或者是一些迷信的，或者是一些自为是的这个道理。
Very easy when we are in any situation that is not favorable,
很容易的，当我们面对一些不利于我们的事情的时候，
we listen to other voices.
我们通常都是听别人的声音。
But what God wanted us to come to Him, listen and obey.
但是呢，我们上帝想要我们去到他面前而俯听从他的声音。
So, Edward, you just say about listening to the voices. Where can we listen to this voice?
那你可能会说，Edward, 你刚才说了我们需要听从上帝的声音，但是我可以在哪里听到呢？
You can listen to this voice early in the morning when you're doing your quiet time.
那可能你早上清晨起来的时候，你可以听到他的声音。
You can listen to this voice when probably on Sunday you listen to a certain message.
可能你在星期日听到一些布道的时候，你可以听到他的声音。
When perhaps during your praise and worship time.
可能你在赞美他的时候。
As long as you are willing just to open your hearts and open your mind.That is where you can listen to this voice.
只要你愿意把你的心打开，那你有兴趣想要跟他联系的话，你就会听到他的声音。
Let me share with you a little bit about my personal encounter with God on listening to His voice.
那我跟你分享一下我自己听到他的声音的这个见证。
There was a time actually I was praying for certain directions in my ministry.
那有一个时期呢，我在为了我的这个领袖而这个事工而祷告。
So when I was praying to God,
当我在祷告的时候
，But I asked God, show me the way. Where do I need to serve you?
那我向上帝祷告说，让我看见你想要我在哪个领域。
I came from a Chinese background.
那我的背景呢是华人的背景。
And today, if I can speak to you in this English, I consider actually a miracle.
那如果今天我的跟你说英文的话，这其实是一个奇迹。
I accepted the Lord since 1984. I accepted the Lord.
Okay, 我在1984年的时候接受耶稣基督。
Come to think of it, it's 40 years, huh?
那现在想想，已经40年了。
So it was long years.
已经很长的一段时间了。
But as I believe in the Lord,
那我相信他的时候
I continue to pray,
我一直继续的祷告
and I see how God let me listen to this voice of directions.
那上帝让我看到了我应该怎样服从这个声音
As I was praying in the morning and I quiet down, I allow God to speak to me.
当我祷告完毕过后呢，我会有一段时间安静下来，让他有时间可以跟我对话。
It is not just one incident, of course, there are many, many other incidents, and this is how I listen to the voice of God.
当然不只是这样子一次的事件，还有其他的事情，但是呢，这就是我如何服从他的声音。
So after listening to the voice, what I have to do?
那我听了他的声音，我需要做什么呢？
The second process.
那第二个过程。
You have to follow carefully.
那你需要小心仔细的跟行。
Or carefully follow. It says in the verse 1, and carefully follow all his commands.
然后在第一节我们可以看到你需要遵行他的一切诫命。
So after we have known his voice, then we have to do things that please God.
那我们听到他的声音过后呢，我们就应该遵循他的这个他的话语。
So when we do things that please God, that we sometimes have to ignore things that it doesn't please God.
那当我们想要取悦、遵循或者取悦我们天父的时候呢，有时候我们需要就是，去拒绝一切外来的声音。
You know why God have Moses to remind the Israelites in Deuteronomy?
那为什么上帝要摩西去提醒，在生命中提醒这些以色列人呢？
Because the Israelites didn't listen to God and broke these rules.
因为呢，他们没有听从上帝的话语，然后呢，打破了他的规矩。
For an example, they worship false God.
那他们去敬拜这个不实的上不实的神。
They complained.
然后他们埋怨。
Yep, they're disloyal to God.
他们有这个不忠的行为。
So and because of this, they had to roam around the desert for 40 years.
就是因为这个关系呢，他们需要在这个沙漠上呢环游了40年。
So allow me to ask you this morning, have you been wandering around at your spiritual desert for 40 years? Maybe not 40 years, but long enough to get to the place.
那我想今天早上想要问一下大家，有没有一直在就是在属灵上在精神上呢一直在你的沙漠的徘徊，是可能没有40年，但是呢已经很久了，还没进入到你的应许之地。
To people on site or to people online that you are listening,
那些在现场或者是在线上聆听的人，
Not all of us will have that 40 years.
不是每个人都有那个40年。
You may accept Jesus at a later time.
那你可能在不是你没有这么早接受到耶稣。
So I urge you to really to leave this desert as soon as possible.
所以我恳求大家呢，尽快逃离这个沙漠。
By listen and obey.
听从和遵守。
And carefully follow what God says.
然后你要跟行上帝所说的。
Okay, second point.The first one is source of blessing. Who is your blesser? The second point, the source of blessings. What sort of blessings that you will get?
那第二点呢，是祝福的种类。你会受到怎样的祝福呢？
Okay, for us who listen, obey, and follow these words, okay, his words and his works, words and works, there is nothing against it.
那些听从和遵守他的话语跟他的功的人呢，是这些律法呢是没有被禁止的。
In Galatians 5:23 said there is no law against these things.
加拉太书第五章二十三节说到，这样的事没有律法禁止。
And also you'll receive some of the blessings that we're going to discuss later.
然后呢，你不止这样，你还会收到这些祝福。
The first one, the blessings of protection.
第一，你会被守护。
Wherever they are geographically.
不管你在哪一个地方。
Like in Deuteronomy 28 verse 3 said, whether you are in the city, whether you are in the country, you will be protected.
Amen. 就第三节说到，你在城里必蒙福，在田间也必蒙福。
Meaning that actually wherever you go, you will be blessed, you will be protected.
就代表着说，不管你在哪里，你都会被保护。
Like this morning during the pre-service prayer, we pray for people who areNow in outstation back to the hometown, or they are probably in holidays.
就好像今天早上我们为那些在外城的这些，我们就为他们祷告。
Wherever they are, they will be blessed.
那不管他们在哪里，他们都会被祝福。
We pray that God will grant them journey mercy.
我们向上帝祷告呢，他们的这个旅程呢会平安。
We also pray that they will have physical health.
我们也为他们祷告，他们的身体健康。
That is the blessings of protection.
那个是被守护的福。
The second blessing is the blessings of prosperity.
第二点是兴旺。
Through their offsprings.
通过他们的下一代。
Through their crops.
他们的产的果子。
Through their works of their hand.
还有他们所做的工作。
Verse 4 it says here.Also blessed with the fruit of the body.
那第十节说到呢，你所生的地所产的。
It's not about just yourself.
不只是你一个人而已。
It's about generational.
这个是世世代代的。
Today, if you think you just invest time treasure and talent in the church just for this generation, then we are wrong.
那如果你觉得你只是投资在这一代的话，那你就错了。
Whatever that we do now is not just only for ourselves.
不管我们现在做了什么，不只是给我们而已。
Whatever we do, there is an impact for the next generation.
那我们现在做的任何事呢，都对下一代是有关系的。
If you look at the young people at the back there, Aaron, Samuel, yeah, Joshua, Daniel, Bella, and many others that is going to come, these are the next generation.
那如果你看一下我们的这些青少年的话，这些是我们的下一代。
If you look at the elderly people like Josephine, yeah, we look at Sister Esther and many others here. These are the generation church.
那你再看一下我们的一些长辈，这些呢是我们世世代代的世代的这个教会。
Prosperity doesn't come with just for yourself.
那这个兴旺呢，不只是给你而已。
It is for your generation, the generation of the next generation and the next generation.
它是给世世代代接传下去的。
Until the Lord come home.
直到上帝回到这里为止。
Bear that in mind, is the blessings of prosperity for multiple is generational.
那这个福呢，是给世代的世代兴旺的。
The third blessings is the blessings of provision.
那第三个是供应的这个祝福。
It says here in the Deuteronomy 28 verse 8 here.
那第八节我们可以看到。
It talk about filling up your storehouses.
它是讲到在你的仓房里。
Your household will be blessed.
那你的家仓房呢会被祝福。
Financially blessed.
在财务上。
Health blessed.
在健康上。
In all areas in relationship, be blessed.
在所有的方面，尤其在你感情上，也是会被赐福。
This blessing is more than enough; it's exceeded than what you ask and what you pray for.
那这个福呢？这一份祝福呢，是多过超越你所祷告的。
The fourth blessings.
第四点。
The blessings of your position.
那你这个身份的赐福。
God's as God holy people.
身为上帝的圣洁的人。
It says here in verse 10.
第十节我们可以看到。
Then all people of the earth shall see that you are called by the name of the Lord, and they shall be afraid of you.
天下万民见你归在耶和华的名下，就要惧怕你。
Meaning that when people hear that you know they are back up, you have God with you, they demonstrate respect to you.
当人家知道你呢靠背呢是上帝的时候，他们就会尊敬你。
Look at the nations today, as Israel today, even they are small country.
我们一起看一下以色列，虽然他们只是一个小的国家。
In the conflict that they are in today.
那现在他们处在的这个状况里。
Do you think it's easy to take on Israel?
那你觉得他们容易吗
？It is God's chosen nation.
是上帝选择的这个国家。
Church.
教会。
All the blessings in this season is for everyone.
那这个季节的这份福气呢，是给所有人的。
Allow me to remind you again, you have to listen and obey.
那我再提醒你，你需要听从和遵守。
And carefully follow.
然后你要细心的跟行他的话语。
And this is how you will be blessed.
这就是你将会被怎样被赐福。
The third blessings.
第三个祝福。
It is a seasons of blessings.
那是祝福的季节。
We already know who is the source of blessing.
我们已经知道是谁赐福于我们。
We already know what sort of blessing that you will get.
我们已经知道我们会得到怎样的祝福。
We want you to know also the seasons of blessing.
也想要让你知道这个祝福的季节。
In verse 12, it says here, the Lord will open to you His good treasure, the heavens, to give the rain to your land in its season.
那耶和华必为你打开天上的府库，按时降雨在你的地上。
God promised people who listen and obey and follow through, He will pour out the blessings.
那他答应那些跟随他听从并且跟随他的话，他会降雨在你的地上。
Not because God is selective.
不是因为他拣选。
His grace, he's graceful, and his grace is free.
那他的恩典呢是免费的。
But even though it's free,
但是就算是免费的,
but it's priceless,
是无价的。
Freely receive, freely given.
是我们可以自由的收获，也是可以自由的给出去的。
I think most of us here, we have really received this salvation for an eternal life.
那我们大多数的人呢，已经收到了这一份就是救赎。
You need to know salvation is a gift.
那我们需要知道救赎呢是一份礼物。
You can't earn salvation.
那你不能赚取这份礼物的。
Because it is a gift.
因为它是一份礼物呢。
It cannot lead you to a reward.
那你不能，它不是带领你得到另外一个奖赏呢。
It is the words that we say, it's the works that you're going to do that will lead you to the rewards.
那是我们所说的话语和我们做的事呢，将带领我们得到我们的奖赏。
Now, think again just now what we have said, freely received and freely given.
那我们想一下刚才我们说的自由的收到自由的给出去
I think all of us here there was a time that you accept Jesus Christ
那在座的所有各位有我们在一段时期呢接受了耶稣基督
You have freely received the salvation
那你已经接受了这个救赎
But how did you receive this salvation
那你是怎样得到的呢
It is someone words it is someone works pour onto you
是某些人的话语跟某些人的工作
come to you
来到你的身上
then you have this opportunity to receive salvation
所以你才有机会接受这个救赎
it's like saying Matthew chapter 10 verse 8 here freely receive freely gift
那就好像我们可以在马太福音看到白白的来白白的舍去
And now after you have received
然后现在你已经接受了
What's the next part?
那下一步要做什么呢
It is to freely given
是要白白的舍去
It is your turn
是你的时间
Your turn, your words, your work go out to someone else.
现在是你的时候呢，把这些话语跟你一做一些工作呢，把这些传达出去。
Then only we can live out this great commission said by Jesus, go make disciples of all nations.
那我们才能呢，应许他的这个吩咐，让我们到世界各地去做有更多的这个门徒。
We have said just now a lot about the Old Testament. You said, Edward, that is the Old Testament.
那可能你会觉得 Edward, 那些都是旧约里的。
I want you to know, remember, the Ten Commandments, it is a relationship.
那我想要让你再提醒你，那十条诫命呢，是你的一段关系。
Let's take a look of how Jesus disciples his disciples with this teaching.
那我们一起看一下这个教导呢，他怎样在他的门徒上使用
？Okay, we are just not going to read verse by verse, but it is recorded in these scriptures in Luke chapter 5, verse 1 to verse 11. You can go back and read this.
那大家可以看一下，在路加福音第五章第一到十一节。
It is actually at the time Jesus was with his disciples.
那耶稣呢，跟他的门徒在一起。
Jesus was calling his disciples.
他在呼唤他的门徒。
The scenario was at this Sea Genesaret, or what we call a Sea of Galilee.
那这个事情是发生在加利利海。
Jesus used Simon's boat to teach the people gathered on the shore.
那他使用了西门的这个船。
So when Jesus finished his teaching,
那耶稣教导他们完毕之后呢？
He told Simon Peter.
他告诉西门彼得。
He said, "Simon, go out and cast this net into the sea."
他让西门呢把他的这个网呢撒向海里去。
And this Simon thought that you know they have catch fish for the whole night.
那西门呢就觉得他已经捕了一整晚的鱼。
There's no fish.
但是却没有捕到。
But because of what Jesus said,
但是因为是耶稣说的
These people throw out the net.
他就把网撒下去。
It is clearly recorded in Luke chapter 5, verse 5, it says here.
那我们可以看到在路加福音第五章第五节。
Simon answered.
西门说。
Master, we have worked hard all night and haven't caught anything.
我们夫子，我们整夜劳力，并没有打着什么。
But because you say so.
但依从你的话。
Because you say so.
因为你说。
Listen and obey.
他听从和遵行。
I will let down the nets.
我就下网。
Follow carefully.
他就跟行。
Cast the net onto the deep water. Yeah?
他们就把他的网撒到海里去。
So what happened then?
那发生了什么呢？
You know, they caught the whole boat of fish, and the boat is almost sink.
那他们捕到了很多鱼，而且那个船呢，差一点就沉下去了。
Experience sometimes may tell us, "Aiyah, Edward, don't waste time lah. We have tried this kind of method before, won't work one lah."
那可能你的经验呢，会告诉你，哎呀，不用的啦，我们已经试过很多次了，不可能的。
Whatever you say, this one we will not work one lah.
那不管你讲什么，都不可能的。
I share Jesus with the person, don't know how many umpteen times or so, he never wanted to come to the church or so.
那我跟这个人分享了耶稣很多次，但是呢，他都不会来的。
But you know what? We are just told to listen and obey.
但是你知道什么吗？我们只是需要听从跟遵守。
And carefully follow.
然后跟行他。
Do nothing else.
什么都不需要做。
Let God come into its season of harvest.
那上帝呢，自然会有他的时间，他的季节。
Brothers and sisters,
弟兄姐妹。
This is the blessings that God wanted us to have.
那这是上帝想要我们拥有的这个祝福。
I want to share with you one testimony.
那我想要跟大家分享一个见证。
This testimony was about someone named Brother Horn.
那他的名字呢，叫Brother Horn. 韩弟兄。
Okay, this Brother Horn is a fantastic guy.
他是一个非常棒的人。
You know, when we ask him, Brother Horn, do you have any testimony or anything?
那我们问他，韩弟兄，你有什么见证吗？
Testimony. Okay, please pray. I can finish all my company entertainment fee.
那他让我们为他祷告，我可以用完就是公司给的这个去就是应酬的这个消费。
Never once we have listened from him saying that I need a job.
那我们从来没有听过你说过你需要一份工作。
Never once we listened to him that I need certain healings.
我们没有听过他需要一些医治。
Never once is you hear before about the children run away from home.
那我们没有听过他听他提起过他的小孩离家出走了。
Even until 6 or 7 years ago, I was serving at the church, ran back and helped a group of youth.
那甚至呢，六七年前我回到那个教会呢，然后我的帮忙就是一些青少年。
I could still have a sense to talk to him, to really, you know, to see.To listen from him.
那我还是有时间呢去听他。
So from what he experienced now for the blessings that Brother Horn has today.
那从他今天来看呢，他所得到的祝福呢
？I found out.
那我发现
，It is what all the good works done by the Father.
都是他。他的父亲所做的这些事工
generational
是世世代代的。
It is the father who has served in the church in Johor.
是他的爸爸呢，在Johor的一间教会呢服事。
He was an elder in the church.
那他是那个教会的长辈。
Served the church,
然后
fervently,
非常认真诚恳的服事教会。
Because of this blessing, it was passed down to Brother Horn.
那就是因为这个祝福呢，传宗接代到了韩弟兄。
And I'm seeing his children also inheriting these blessings.
那我看到的孩子呢，也是接受到这份祝福。
Church,
教会。
It is not for this generation only.
那这个祝这份祝福呢，不是只是给我们而已。
It is this source of blessings.
那这一份祝福呢
？This what do you call that? A sort of blessings.
那这一类型的祝福
These seasons of blessings
这个季节的祝福呢
is for multiple generations
是给世世代代传承下去的
So this is Chinese New Year
那农历新年呢
I thought it is good to speak something that is good like blessings talk about you know not about curse you know yeah talk about blessings to all of you
那我觉得应该跟大家一起分享就是好的事情赐福
we want to encourage each other
那我想要鼓励大家
in this church
在这个教会
never see yourself as too young people at the back
不要觉得大家自己太年轻
you can do a lot more far more
那你是可以做很多很多很多事情的
People who are adults, 40s, 50s, you can do more as well.
那那些40、50岁的，你也可以做很多。
For those who are 60s, 70s, 80s, you can do more.
那些60岁到80岁的，你也是可以做很多事情。
It depends on whether you want to do it or not.
是关乎你想不想要做。
You want to listen and obey?
你要听从和遵守吗
You want to carefully follow what God said?
那你要跟行他所说的吗
These are the blessings.
这些就是那些祝福
That you will definitely get because this is not my promise.
那那些祝福你肯定会收到因为这不是我应许的
Remember what we said just now?
还记得我们刚才说的吗
Deuteronomy 28, it is about 14 verses of blessings.
那在《生命记》第二十八章是有十四节是说到祝福、赐福的。
54 verses about curses.
那有五十四节呢是说到诅咒。
Curses or blessings is your choice.
那你要想要被赐福呢，还是想要被诅咒呢？是你的选择。
Okay, let's pray.
那我们一起祷告。
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.We thank you. We thank you for the God of blessing, Father. Father, we know that all of us here, Father, Lord, we are longing for your blessings, Father, Lord. Lord, we know that you are God. That is, you are the blesser. You are the source of all blessings, Father, Lord. You give all sorts of blessings to us. And according to your seasons, Father, Lord. Lord, at this morning, Father, Lord, as we come before you, Father, Lord. Any of you want the blessing of God? Can I see your hand here?This morning, the blessing of God.
谁要想收到上帝的祝福的
？Yeah, yeah. Father, we see these hands, Father Lord. We see this hand longing for your blessings, Father Lord. Lord, give them a heart that they will listen and obey to you, Father. They will follow you carefully, Father Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We know that you are God. That you are God of promises. You are the same.Yesterday, today, and tomorrow. Whatever that we do, Father, wherever that we are, Father, Lord, as we listen and obey to you, we follow through, Father, Lord, Lord, we will be blessed. Amen. Hallelujah. We will be blessed. Father, we commit our church congregation into your hand, Father, Lord, for people who are on site this morning, Father, Lord, for every one of them serving on stage, serving on the ground,Serving in all areas, in their families, not only this generation, Father, in the generation to come, Father, Lord. Lord, pray that the people who are away at the hometown, away for holiday, Father, they will be blessed too, Father, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We commit this church into your hand. We want to be a church that shines, Father, Lord, in this community that around us. That our community will be blessed, Father, Lord. And this is a growing church.This growing church will be part of your expansion of your kingdom, Father. Father, we thank you. We commit each and every one of us into your hand. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you, Pastor Edward.
Now let's stand up together and let's clap our hands. Let's clap our hands. Hallelujah.
Today, I'm leaving all my troubles behind. I'm letting go of all of the lies, holding on all of my life. I see a rising sun that's only just begun.
Let's sing it again.
Today, I'm walking to the beat of your heart. You take me all the way to the stars. Stretch your hand straight and apart. I'm found in open skies. Your heart lives in mine. Today, I'm finding my first love.
gather around and we have refreshments provided, so yeah.
It's about Bible reading plan.